Hello everyone. Next we are going to see the new topic in third unit, that is link state routing. In the previous video we have seen distance vector routing. So in distance vector routing we will be circulating the entire routing table to the nearest neighbors, but here we will send only the link state information to the nearest neighbors. That is the main difference between the two. So link state routing, what is the main aim of link state routing? Is to find the optimum path or shortest path from every node to from one node to all other nodes. That is the main aim of link state routing. So link state routing, it uses Dijkstra's algorithm to execute this process. So there are two phases in this link state routing. One is flooding. So what do you mean by the flooding? Is after it find out its link state information, it will flood that information to the entire network. That is the flooding. The second phase is called to calculate the route calculation using Dijkstra's algorithm. So there are two phases. First phase is it will do flooding. It will find out the link state, and it will link state information is flooded across the network. The second is it is uses Dijkstra's algorithm to do find out the shortest path. First we will see what is link state information. Okay, so suppose for example you have a network like this, internet like this, A, which is connected to C, then D, B, E, and here you have F. So all six nodes has been connected and all the links have been associated with cost. Okay, so how do you find out the link state? So A, it will find out the link state is nothing but the information regarding the node, the nearest neighbors, and the cost involved in connecting to that neighbors. Suppose A can reach B and C only with the cost 3, and it can reach C with the cost 2. So this is the link state information for A. And for C, the link state information is C can reach A, D, and F. So A, D, and F with the cost 2, 1, 2, 1, and 2. So if you see this B can reach A, then D and E directly. So the cost involved we have written here. So E can reach D, B, and F directly. So the cost involved I have written here. And for D, it can reach C, A, B, and E. That the cost involved I have written here. And for this F, it can reach only C and E. So I have written this information. So this is the link state information. Instead of sending the entire routing table, so here it will send only the nearest neighbors information across the entire network. So A will get the link state information of B, C, D, E, F. Likewise, C will get the link state information of A, D, B, E, F. Every node will find out the link state information. It will flood the entire network with this information. So this is the first process. First process is flooding. The second process is Dijkstra's algorithm. It has to use Dijkstra's algorithm to find out the shortest path. So the algorithm is like this. So first the tree, you have to find out the least cost tree. So in this, initially the root node will be the tree. So for every node inside that network, we have to process this information. First, if there is only one node, then we can say the distance is zero. And if you have a neighbor for this root node, and you have to find out the cost involved between this root node and the neighbor node, and that will be the distance. Else, if there is no direct contact with this, and you have to add infinity to that value. So this is the first process. The second process is that you have to repeat. You have to find out the least cost tree. So for this, for every node, first you have to find out the node with the minimum distance from the root node. And you have to add that node to the tree. After adding it to the tree, and you have to check which is if there is any node which is having a nearest smallest path between that neighbor. Okay, that you can find out with this Bellman's Ford algorithm. And you have to repeat this process until you proceed with all other nodes. Okay, we will see with an example, then you will understand this Dijkstra's algorithm. So first, initially the tree is root. For all the nodes inside the tree, you have to check for three conditions. One, if this is a root node, the distance involved is zero. If you have a neighbor node for this root node, you have to find out the cost involved between the two nodes. If there is no direct contact with the neighbors, then you have to set the value to be infinity. And you have to repeat, first you have to find out the nearest minimum distance node, and you have to add that tree to that, add that value to the tree. And for every node x which is a neighbor, you have to find out which is the minimum distance for reaching that particular node, and you have to add that node to the tree. Likewise, you have to repeat one by one, and you have to add every other node to the tree. Okay, at last we will get the least cost tree. This is what your Dijkstra's algorithm. So now we will see how you are going to do this process. Okay, so first initially, okay, next we see how Dijkstra's algorithm works for this example. If you take the same example, like A, B, C, D, E, F, it has been connected. So we need to use this Dijkstra's algorithm to find out the shortest path. Okay. So here what we have to do is that we have, using Dijkstra's algorithm, we have to find out the shortest path from the source node, that is root node, that is A. Okay, from here the iteration, the first iteration is initial iteration. Now initially starting with the initial iteration. Okay, so initially we add the tree, we'll visit this first node, that is your A node. So from there we will check, what is the cost involved from reaching the other nodes. So here it is mentioned to reach B the cost involved is 3, and to reach C it is cost involved is 2, and to reach D it is 5. So these three nodes are directly connected, and the node E and F which are not directly connected with A, so we doesn't know the distance, so we will give it as infinity over here. Okay, next we go for the next iteration, that is first iteration. In the first iteration, we will check in this among the distances which is having the shortest distance. So here 2 is having the shortest distance when we compared with all the cost. So what we have to do is that we will add this particular C node to the tree. So we will get A comma C. So we will visit A and then we will visit C. Okay, we have visited A node, now we are going to visit C node. So that is why we have added the C node to the tree. So what we now we have to check, so what is the distance or cost involved in reaching other nodes. So you can reach it from A, or otherwise you can reach pass through C and you can reach other nodes. So when we go to this B node, directly we can reach from A, so the distance involved is 3. C, we leave it since already we have visited. Okay, next coming to the D node, so it can be visited from A, it is 5, through C it is 4. So we will take the minimum distance using Bellman-Ford algorithm. So the minimum distance will be 4 over here. And E, when you go for E, it is E cannot be directly connected, so we are going to give infinity. And you are going for the F node you can reach through C, it is a distance is 2 plus 1, that is a minimum distance, so it is 3 over here. So this is your the first iteration. So now we have to compare which is having the smallest node. So here 3 is having the smallest cost, so we are going to the next iteration, we are going to add this particular node to the tree. So A comma B comma C. So we have already visited A, C. Now we are visiting this B also. Okay, from A. So you can reach other nodes through A, C, or otherwise through A, B. So first we'll go for D. So when you go for D, through A, C, it is the cost, total cost involved is 4. And through this A, B also the cost involved is 4. Directly if you're going, it is 5. So the minimum cost is anyway it is 4. Here it is 4, here it is 4, it is 5. So the minimum distance is, here it will be, so it will be 4 over here. And for B, we are not writing since already we have visited. Okay, for D, I am writing it the minimum distance, so it is 4 over here. Next, we go for E. So when we go for E, the minimum distance, total cost will be, here it will be 7. When you go this, here only 7 you can reach. Because C, you have to go through D and then E, which is not possible. You can reach this E through AB, or otherwise, that's all, only one route is there. So it will be 7. 7 is the cost for reaching your E node through B. Okay, next coming to F. When you are coming to F, you can reach this AC, then F. So the total distance is 3 over here, the same distance. So now you have to compare the minimum cost. minimum cost among all the cost is 3, so which is the note F. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this note to your least cost tree, that is F you're going to add. So you have already visited ACB, now you are visiting this F also. Okay, you are visiting this F also. So now you have to check, already BC has been visited, so D we need to check what is the minimum cost. So you can reach this like this, or otherwise you can reach through C, or otherwise you can reach to B. So the same cost, the minimum cost will be 4 over here. And then coming to E, so you can reach here through here it is 7, the same 7. Okay, and coming to F, it's already visited, so you are going to give dash over there. Okay, now you have to compare. So one more thing, so here when you want to reach E, you can also reach like this also, A, C, F, E, which is the cost involved will be 2 plus 1 plus 2. So that will be 5. So when you're reaching from here, it will be 7. When you're reaching through A, C, F, you're going to get 5. So you're going to write the minimum cost. So it will be 5 over here. Okay. So the 5 over here. So now you have to compare the minimum cost among all the other nodes. So here only 4 is having the minimum cost. So you're going to add D to this tree. So you'll get A, B, C, D and then F. Okay, so you have already visited this D. Now you have visited this D also. Okay, you have visited this D also. Now you have B already visited, C already visited, D is also visited and F is already visited. Only E you have to find out the total cost. So we will compare which is the minimum cost involved in reaching E, whether you can reach it through B or otherwise through 3. So when you are reaching here, you are going to get 7. When you are reaching from here, it is you are going to get 8. When you are reaching from this side, you are going to get 5. So which is the minimum cost? Only 5 is minimum cost. So the 5 is there. So at last I'm going to add this, only one node is there. I'm going to add that node also to this. So that will be, so this is what we have reached all the other nodes. So now we have to find out the least cost tree. So the node has been transferred like this. This is an actual node. So if you see this, this is the actual node B, D, this is E. So the main aim of this algorithm is to find out the shortest path from one node to all other nodes. So the cost involved is 2, 5, 3, 1, 4, 3, this side 2, 1, 2. So after using this Dijkstra's algorithm, we found out that this algorithm, so we are reaching C3, like we are reaching C, to we are reaching this C with the help of two distance, okay, and we are going to next, we are reaching the node called B with a distance called 3, so it is 3 it is mentioned, okay, and we are reaching this F node with a distance called 1, okay, and we are reaching this D node with a distance called 4, that is 2 plus 2, 4, okay, 2 plus 2, 4, and then we are reaching next is E node through the distance called 2 plus 1 plus 2. So this will be 5. That is nothing but 5. 2 plus 1 plus 2. Okay, this is 5. So this is your shortest path, or otherwise we can say this is the shortest path for finding out this using Dijkstra's algorithm. We have found this. So using link state routing, what we have done is we have used Dijkstra's algorithm to find out the shortest path for this particular tree. Do you all understood this? So what we are going to do is that first we have to find out the link state information, and we have to flood this link state information to all through all the nodes in your network. After that, we have to use Dijkstra's algorithm to find out the shortest path. Okay. So how to use this link state information is, only the link state information contains only the next neighbor nodes and the cost involved in reaching the next node. This information will be flooded across the network. With the help of this, and you can able to find out, you can able to easily find out the shortest route. So this is a network which has been given. So we have to put one tabular column. In this, you have an iteration tree and all other nodes to reach from source node. So here source node is A. So here we have to find out what is the cost involved in reaching all the other nodes. Since E and F cannot be directly connected, so we have given infinity over here. Among the all other nodes, 2 is having the least cost. So we are going to select this two C node which will be added to the tree, and again we are going to select and we are going to see the next node which is near, which is having the shortest path from reaching A from source node A through C, and like this we are going to find out all other nodes, and we are going to add all the other nodes into the tree. After that we can able to derive this particular least cost tree. Okay, thank you.